Good afternoon, everybody. Today we are with Dr. Dheeraj Bhatia. He is a senior medical advisor to VLCC.
Hi, everybody.
So today we are going to talk about insulin resistance. So insulin resistance के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं वो diabetes होता है?
No, it's not diabetes. It's I will not even say it's pre-diabetes because not everybody with insulin resistance will get this condition. Okay. Not everybody is going to go into diabetes. Okay. So insulin resistance is just insulin resistance.
Insulin resistance के बारे में बात करने से पहले let's talk about insulin.
वो
क्या
होता
है body में कैसे होता है?
So insulin is a hormone which regulates the glucose. Let's say you had meat, which had glucose in it. So that has to be regulated. Mm-hmm. So that is what it is doing. It is regulating your
blood sugar.
Your blood sugar. So it's very, yeah, which is glucose, and which is.
So can you explain further? We have a diagram so that you can explain further.
You want the diagram? Yeah, yeah. Sure.
This is the blood sugar you were talking about.
Taken a meal. There's glucose, and then let's say this is your muscle. Let me take just one cell to make things simple.
Okay.
And this requires, like, if I'm doing some exercise, if I'm doing, let's say, dumbbells or I'm running or swimming, it requires energy.
Okay.
Energy is going to be glucose, which is coming in from the blood.
Yeah.
But the way nature's made it, it's not that simple. Mm. There are receptors here.
Okay.
And these receptors have to be open, and these are called insulin receptors.
Okay.
So ye jab khulenge, then the blood, the glucose is going to go in and provide energy.
Now, insulin कहाँ से रहा है?
So insulin is coming from this gland.
Okay.
So this is the pancreas.
Okay.
So इसमें there are beta cells which are in the islands of Langerhans, and these beta cells are the ones which release insulin, which opens these receptors.
Okay.
You can say they're like gatekeepers.
अच्छा.
So that is open, great. This thing is going to go in.
Okay.
But what happens is in resistance, these receptors get blocked.
How?
Now, there are many theories. There's post signaling, but one of the most important theories is that it's going to get blocked because of free fatty acids coming from here.
Okay.
As you can see, this great central obesity.
Yeah.
And these free fatty acids, they combine with some three kind of proteins and inflammatory substances called cytokinins.
Okay.
So ye combine karke, they, whatever, main thing one has to remember, they form a kind of protein complex and they go and they block these receptors. So when these receptors get blocked, my muscle or my certain part of the body sending messages to the pancreas. Please help me. हाँ, insulin आया नहीं. Insulin is the gatekeeper. इसको खोलो तभी तो energy होएगी.
अच्छा.
So then the pancreas responds by releasing insulin to open the receptors.
तो resistance का मतलब ये हुआ कि normally जो glucose body में आ रहा था, cells में आना चाहिए था,
right.
इन gates से.
हाँ.
Gates का watchman insulin आया, लेकिन gates पे ताला लग गया इस मोटापे की वजह से.
Correct. That's the reason.
Okay. So that's insulin resistance.
So when we come to the management later, that's when we will talk about it being so important to knock this fat belly off.
Then why is this liver over here?
Okay, so now this is sending messages to the pancreas that release insulin.
Yeah.
See, in a way, crying out because there's no energy. Mm-hmm. Crying out the cells that please release insulin. Mm-hmm. Insulin is supposed to open this.
Okay.
But now there's too much of insulin in the blood, and what insulin is doing when there's too much of it in the blood, the glucose is converted to glycogen.
Okay.
So it converts glucose into glycogen.
Okay.
And when there's a lot of glycogen, then less fat is utilized.
Okay.
Less fat is utilized. Also, insulin by itself, more, it makes more fat to be synthesized. That's why insulin is called a lipogenic hormone.
Yani fat-producing hormone.
Hormone. That's why they call it a lipogenic hormone.
So this is the key. Body mein nahi ja pa raha hai, us excessive glucose ko isthe fat bana ke liver mein daal
diya.
So isliye fatty liver likha hua.
That's why fatty liver is
there. Okay.
So that's why I've written fatty liver is donated by triglycerides.
Okay.
So triglycerides are higher form of free fatty acid.
Okay.
So when the triglycerides are high, they start choking the liver. In a way, they start choking the liver.
Okay.
So once they're choking the liver, the good cholesterol, the अच्छा cholesterol है, that is the HDL.
अच्छा.
वो नहीं बन पा रहा है. So when the HDL becomes low, then our cardiac risk increases.
Heart problems शुरू हो जाते हैं.
Yes. Or strokes can increase.
Okay.
Or blockages in various arteries.
Okay.
So next, like you were wondering what HDL is,
yeah.
I can see that. So HDL is actually just called the cleaner or the sweeper.
Okay.
So you're sitting in a nice room. Let's say it's freshly made, well designed, everything fine. Don't let it dry to clean it for 10 days. Kya hoega?
Kharab
ho jayega. So HDL is that's why the good cholesterol is the cleaner. So that's why the HDL will fall, the triglycerides will rise, and then you'll have the central obesity and high insulin. And one more thing happens: high blood pressure.
Okay. But blood pressure also.
Blood pressure happens because insulin. What it does is it causes sodium retention.
Okay.
So it does not, yes, it does not allow salt to go out from the renal tubules.
Okay.
The salt vega, you have water retention,
mm-hmm.
and subsequently it can lead to hypertension.
Okay.
Also, insulin, it evokes the sympathetic system.
Okay.
Sympathetic system is the system in our body where all the time, when you're getting hyper, you're getting depressed, you're getting, you're running. Like, I think everybody's sympathetic drive very high in this town.
Okay.
That's why road rage, that's part of it.
So basically, we have learned that insulin resistance means these gates, insulin having they are not opening.
Correct.
And on top of it, this insulin is making this glucose instead of going inside the cells.
Yeah, more of it.
It
yeah.
is going inside the liver
yeah, yeah.
as fat.
This is already there, the glucose.
So
this yeah.
cycle to hota hi ja raha hai.
Yeah, this cycle, yeah. So if I don't behave myself, this fatty liver is going to pour out more of this free fatty acid triglycerides,
mm-hmm.
plus of course too much of eating, and that will also cause it. And then what is going to happen? This thing will go and again fill up the adipocytes. Adipocytes are the ones where fat is stored.
Okay.
So this is like sponge.
Okay.
Finally, there will be outpouring. How much is it going to take? So although there are millions, finally it will come out, again combined with these kinins, and then it will go and it will block these things. Then you land up with symptoms. And
doctor, so many people are sitting and watching here.
How do you come to know about the symptoms?
Yeah.
So symptoms actually, if you really, most people will tell you that for there have been no symptoms,
mm-hmm.
but this is not true.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, the first symptom which you're going to get is that there's going to be tiredness.
Tiredness, because it's not going in the cells.
Exactly.
Yeah.
The glucose is not going in the cells. That is why the cells are crying out to the pancreas, it's like a mother.
Yeah.
Like, mother, help me.
Huh.
She releases more insulin.
Okay.
That's all. And then of course that insulin is lipogenic, or fat banata. But basically the first symptom is low energy.
Okay.
So if you've ruled out like anemia, which is the commonest cause of low energy in our country,
correct.
Which is iron deficiency anemia, you've ruled out B12 or low levels, or D3 low levels, and you've ruled out hypothyroid. One thing which I would always look at is insulin resistance.
Okay.
Especially
so,
if there's a family history.
Thakavat ka matlab hai, there's a good chance ki aapko ho sakta hai.
Yes, it
or
could
symptoms?
Be. If you, other symptoms are, like I was saying, it causes sodium retention.
Ji.
So it's very important cause of unexplained edema.
Edema yani bloating?
Water retention,
okay.
Yes. In a way you can say bloating
okay.
or triangle. Very often they'll tell you, like mid-cycle, every woman will say, you know, rings tight ho gaye. That's different. But if you've ruled out any cardiac or any low proteins and any renal problem, liver problem, then this is another thing which one should look at.
Okay, so
very, very high chance that it could be insulin resistance. When there is third very important sign is that there are skin tags.
Skin tags.
It could be genetic, but very often you will have skin tags.
Okay.
And you can also have a thing called acanthosis nigricans. So that is a name given when you get these blackened hyperpigmented spots. They can come, usually they come under the armpits or in the groin, and especially the upper end of the groin, and in women under the breast.
Okay.
Sometimes I've seen them on the knuckles also.
Yeah.
Insulin, they feel, actually the problem is insulin resistance is one part of the term.
Okay.
The other is what we call hyperinsulinemia, which
okay.
means hyper means high, insulin is insulin, inemia means blood. So the consequence, the next subsequent thing is, from insulin resistance, it goes to high insulin levels.
Okay.
Because the blockage is there, so the pancreas are releasing more insulin.
So a person realizes that it can happen.
Correct.
So after that, like diabetes, we get a blood test done.
Right.
Correct. And many people have tested blood test, but insulin has not been caught.
Correct. Correct.
So how will you come to know? Because insulin resistance, I have never tested.
Yeah. So actually, a lot of people, first, you know, there's another thing which is very important. Insulin as a test is not a very good test to do. Like like you have a fasting blood sugar, you have fasting insulin. So then they do something like Puma, which is ratios with sugar, but that's also out now. Not a very good idea to insulin, because insulin has got a very short half-life. It comes and it goes off very fast. Those of some, they call it the first pass into the liver.
Okay.
So it's metabolized very fast. If you pick up insulin, you're lucky.
Okay.
But more often than not, you're not going to pick up fasting and PP. PP means 2 hours later, insulin. So we actually then go by other parameters.
Can you give an example of a situation like this?
Before that, let me tell you clinically how we do it. When somebody comes to my clinic, very interestingly, a long time back, when we had no concept of insulin, like two sisters came to me.
Okay.
Twins, absolutely alike.
Okay.
Their eyebrows were the same, their eyes were the same, their lips, color, everything was the same. But one was 140 kilos, the other one was 50 kilos.
Mm-hmm.
And the one who was 140, she said, "Doc Saab, look at her. Din raati khari and she's only 50 kilos.
Uh-huh.
And I said, "I'm sorry, I feel bad for you because you are in denial, and we cannot help anybody who is in denial.
But
we just cannot.
So
we used to say, how are you going to get weight loss because you're in denial? So she used to say, no, believe me, I'm not eating. I'm really not eating anything.
Okay.
And I, even when I try, I cannot lose weight.
Okay.
Now, we were of course saying, thinking she's depressed and you know we should get upset with her. Now we have realized, we have absolutely realized that we were so wrong.
Okay.
The problem was that genetically, in the one who's 140 kilos, there's a mutation and her receptors are now blocked.
Okay.
So the body is releasing more insulin in her case.
Okay.
Why? Because she got the genes from her mom.
Okay.
Father was fine. The other one probably, you know, she her inheritance from wherever, it was fine. Maybe from the grandfather's, her inheritance is fine. There'll be no mutation. So her receptors are open. So if your receptors are closed, that is a problem, because then even once the receptors are closed, even if you take a little bit of glucose, insulin will come pouring out, and that will lead to what I've already explained.
So excessive insulin ka problem.
Yeah, excessive insulin ka problem ho raha hai because the receptors are closed.
Okay.
So again my muscle is crying out and sending message to pancreas, help me mother, help me. So the beta cells are releasing insulin and the insulin is creating that havoc. It's a lipogenic hormone, which I already explained that what it does. That's the problem. So this is one way we could tell. The second question was we could tell is by the family history.
Family
history is very important, you could tell. Then history of gestational diabetes. Like a woman comes to us and says, oh, I had diabetes during pregnancy. But I'm fat. You can be sure that her insulin levels are high. And then of course we can also, history of high birth weight babies.
High birth weight?
Yeah, yeah. Then from that diagram, you get a lot of hints.
Okay.
Supposing somebody has central obesity. In fact, I always say charity because at home. If you feel your dad has got central obesity, get his HDL and triglycerides.
Okay.
Show me that diagram. If that HDL is low, like I showed, low HDL, and the triglycerides are high, that could be, if the HDL is low and the triglycerides are high, this could be insulin resistance and hyperinsulinemia or high insulin in the body.
Okay, so it's not only cholesterol
karke chhodni dena. Cholesterol ka naam hi nahi
hai.
It's all metabolic. So it's all related to metabolism. The glucose metabolism goes haywire and the insulin comes in that.
Okay.
Not cholesterol.
So
good cholesterol, yes, but that's because this is not being manufactured here. So we can tell when somebody has got, is trying her best and not losing weight. No diet deviation. Suspect insulin resistance.
Okay.
Somebody gains weight very easily, like this twin, who's 140 from a suspect that there is insulin resistance. Supposing a strong family history, suspect. Then from that diagram, history of gestational diabetes, suspect insulin resistance. Somebody has central obesity, like there, you should suspect. Somebody has low HDL, the good cholesterol, again we suspect insulin resistance. Somebody has high triglycerides, again suspect. Supposing somebody has unexplained loss of energy, no energy, suspect again.
Okay.
Supposing somebody says that blood pressure is there.
Yeah.
So obviously sodium hypertension can lead to high blood pressure.
High blood pressure, yeah.
PCOS. PCOS, you can be sure PCOS 100%, where you don't even have to do OGTT. Now the latest guidelines are don't bother about OGTT or any testing.
Okay.
That you suspect. Sleep apnea, such an important thing.
Okay.
Because it's a stress hormone. It will be relieved as there is less oxygen, as you're choking and as you're snoring. If you have apnea, again, then you have to suspect this condition. So multitude of conditions.
So, don't ignore them, just go and get a checkup done. But then
checkup, like you were discussing, the blood test, because I know what you're aiming at, you want the blood test, no? That's the essence. So the problem is that, like I was saying, fasting insulin, PP insulin don't tell you.
Okay.
You get an idea if there is impaired glucose tolerance. Means aapne fasting sugar kara or PP sugar kara. So there, if there is, it comes not in the diabetic range, in the borderline range. There you can suspect. But very often it will not come like that.
Can you give me an example, doctor? I have that thing.
Yeah, so this we can discuss this and show them. This is a beautiful example. So this lady had wanted, you know, she wanted weight loss and she, you know, wanted about 14 kilos. She joined us. And then what happened with her was she lost about 7.1 kilos.
Okay.
And she, for 2-3 months, was very, very disheartened that what's going wrong with me. So we checked for thyroid, we checked for a whole lot of other things, and any medicines which cause weight gain. So we checked for a whole lot of things. We didn't get anything.
Yeah.
Then I told her, she had a family history.
Okay.
And diabetes. She didn't have history of gestational diabetes.
Okay.
She didn't have fatty liver. So that's why I said you don't get all those parameters.
Okay.
You may get something. So then And she said, what do I do now? Mm-hmm. So I said, you have to do OGTT.
Okay.
Now OGTT, like we were discussing, only drawback is that you have to poke a person 5 times. It's the same thing which you do in pregnancy.
Okay.
But there, the gynecologist, when the obstetrician orders it, mm-hmm. It is with 100 grams of glucose.
Okay.
This we do with 75 grams of glucose.
But here doctor, normal.
So a very good point. So here, if you look at this, I'll explain. This is in, we take the sample at zero, fasting.
Mm-hmm.
Then at 30 minutes, 1 hour, 1.5 hours, 2 hours.
Okay.
That's why I'm saying you take 5 samples.
Okay.
Right? Mm-hmm. And then what happens is, after taking the sample at fasting, you give 75 grams of glucose.
Hmm.
Now, if you see her fasting, she told me, Doctor, why are you poking me 5 times?
Yeah.
My fasting sugar is always 90.
Yeah, normally.
And normally. And sure enough, her fasting sugar was 90.
Correct.
And she said, 2 hours wala mera 130 aata hai. And in fact, if you notice, her PP sugar, 2 hours one, was how much? 110.
It's normal 110,
again normal.
Ji.
Why was it coming 130 earlier and 110 now? Because she probably lost those 7 kilos.
Okay.
But when we gave her this challenge of 75 grams of glucose,
Ji.
Look what happened.
Ekdam se shoot up kar gaya.
Yeah. So this is showing the ascending limb.
Okay.
This is the most important. Most people miss this.
Okay.
This one, you can see how gradually, this is the normal. See, standard reading. Standard
Ji.
Reading is, and so in the dotted line is the patient's reading. So you can see what happens here. It suddenly shoots up and then it comes down gradually, while in this it comes down fast. Now why is this? Because the insulin receptors are blocked in my tissues.
Correct.
So the tissues cannot pick up the glucose.
Correct.
So the glucose is going high in the blood.
Okay.
There it goes.
Yeah.
So it's not being able to go, you know, otherwise if it sweeps into the tissues, it should be like this.
Slowly,
the,
slowly.
But this is showing the, this is a reflection of the blood test.
Okay.
This is reflection of blood test.
Do
so indirectly it? Tells you that the receptor is blocked,
yeah.
The glucose is not going into the tissues,
yeah.
And therefore this is rising. So this rises.
Sab normal hai. Sare, agar hum ek normal diabetes ka test kare, to sab normal hai. Lekin agar ye test karenge, to pata chalega.
Yeah, insulin resistance. Yeah.
Achha.
Diabetes mein to mil jayega because of fasting and PP. You're gonna get it.
Correct.
But in this, this is the only indirect way to get it. Then you have this other test called HbA1c, 3 months average, glycosylated hemoglobin. वो भी उसके IGT level, impaired glucose tolerance level होता है. Borderline, let's make it simple. It's a borderline. If you get a borderline, that could also reflect that you got insulin resistance and high insulin in the body.
Doctor, मान लीजिए कि लगा है insulin resistance. तो अभी diabetes के तो we just take a medicine and we kind of try and deal with it.
Right.
तो क्या हम cure कर सकते हैं? Is it curable? Yeah, it's a.
Yeah, good question. So. Insulin resistance is totally reversible.
Okay.
It's curable.
Okay.
Diabetes is controllable.
Okay.
Very important to understand that.
Okay.
That's why we take great pride in diagnosing this condition,
okay.
And making people lose weight,
okay.
And reversing it.
Okay.
That actually, VLCC done a great job. Hundreds and hundreds of, we got a lot of data.
Okay.
The way we have reversed people with this, and the way we picked it up, all by that clinical thing I told you, and by these, whatever is available to us, these biochemical tests, and then we work on it. But yes, the question that what do? You have to do 3 things.
Okay.
Number one is exercise, exercise, exercise.
So this thing has to go.
This thing has to go.
Yeah.
And the more you exercise, the more the receptors open.
अच्छा अपने आप veins खुलने लग जाते हैं.
Yes, with exercise.
Okay.
Not only that, more important, they found that the more you do exercise, especially cardiovascular, you know what happens? The glucose bypasses the receptors.
Bypasses.
You don't have to, it sweeps in to the tissues. It provides energy.
Okay.
If it provides energy, then what's going to happen?
Ji.
The insulin is not going to come out.
Ji.
We want insulin to be shant.
Achha.
We don't want too much of insulin.
Okay.
Because too much of insulin is lipogenic and more fat is synthesized.
Correct.
We don't want this to happen.
Okay.
And less fat is utilized. We don't want it. So one method is exercise. That's why the fatty liver also, if it's grade 3, it will become grade 2, grade 1 and you can reverse it.
Hmm.
Second thing which we do is, what we do which is very very important is that we, okay, since you're talking about this, let me finish the receptor part.
Okay.
So we also diet we give. So less carbs, especially high glycemic index carbs. High glycemic index means that you take something with less fiber, like juices, like maida, refined flour, sugar will suddenly rise. Sugar suddenly rises, what will the pancreas do? Release more.
Correct.
Of insulin.
और insulin हम चाहते
हैं
कि कम रहे.
और हम चाहते हैं कम रहे. So high glycemic index is actually or very like juices and the colas and the sodas and
basically we need some
aise
sugars खाने चाहिए जिनको time लगे body को digest करने में.
Correct.
Immediate
complex carbs are still alright.
Correct. Okay.
But this is a very good point. You know, this otherwise will create havoc. So diet is one. Yeah, medicines. We have a medicine called metformin, which we give.
It's a weight loss drug, yeah.
No. That's why it's actually a weight neutral drug.
Okay.
It does help because it's also called an insulin sensitizing drug.
Achha.
What does insulin sensitizing mean? That it opens the receptors. In our medical jargon, it means receptors ko kholna.
So work out karne ki to zarurat hi nahi
hai. No, that is what. That's why I don't like prescribing metformin, because the people say, oh, we got a drug. So they chill.
Yeah.
Uske baad then they gain more weight.
Achha.
So metformin, you have to tell the person that you have to exercise, exercise and exercise. The more you exercise, the more and diet of course.
Correct.
As you lose weight, then it works very well.
And
it may help you to lose, but in tandem. You have to exercise, you have to watch your carbs, and then it works. And another interesting thing is fenugreek seeds.
Methi.
So methi is like metformin, has to be taken twice a day, 12-hour reaction. But methi has got a lot of research, you all can check out the net.
Yeah.
It's full of it, it's called saponins.
So saponins
are the ones which help, they help also for the receptor.
So receptors ko kholne
mein help karta hai. Yeah, in a way they do. They're not really sure, but they feel that's one of the theories. Plus it's got fiber. Yeah, but it definitely helps. There are a lot of studies showing that wo insulin levels ko kam karta
hai.
Yeah, and insulin resistance ko kam karta hai. There are a lot of studies coming up.
Okay.
So yeah, that should be done, but at least 2 teaspoons twice a day.
Okay.
But then a lot of people say that we feel very hot with it,
okay,
or we get bitter taste,
okay,
we get acidity.
Yeah.
Then of course we tell them what to do,
okay,
how to handle it.
Doctor, one question.
Hmm.
Fatty liver, what is the treatment for fatty liver?
Yeah, fatty liver. So just show me that once again.
Yeah.
So, you know, concept-wise, because the triglycerides come part of the lipid profile.
Correct.
So everybody says, fat kam karo fat.
Uh-huh.
But this triglyceride is actually coming from glucose.
Yeah.
This fatty liver is more metabolic, and more because this fellow, than that fat itself.
Okay.
So you have to actually make sure that you are going to reduce the carbs and weight loss.
Mm-hmm.
They are very, very important. Then also, which is very, very important for fatty liver, is the latest is that we use vitamin E.
Vitamin E.
Right.
Okay.
And we use almost 800 milligrams. There are no contraindications.
Okay.
Because vitamin E has got one problem, that is anti-clotting also.
Anti-clotting.
Okay. So you have to be very careful if somebody's got a thrombosis or something.
Yeah.
But under the doctor's supervision, you can use vitamin E at a high dose, and with a lot of exercise, low carb diet, you get rid of this. We have reversed this also. Fatty liver can be reversed. And fatty liver can be in people with non-alcohol also.
Yeah, like you said.
Yeah. And then of course there is a very good article which has come out in the editorial in JAPI, which is our main journal, which mentions this, that you can use metformin also for this.
Okay.
Also for this. But like I said, metformin is great if you use it in tandem with all this. There is no shortcuts.
Okay.
So therefore, but this is a very interesting area, because this has been a grey area for a long time.
And
we could pick it up very easily, but now with the blood tests and other things, we can pick it up, and we can do wonders with this. Like I keep saying, it's reversible.
Reversible. So
it's
not diabetes.
Curable. It's not diabetes.
Okay.
If you reach the diabetic levels,
then
you are in trouble. And then all the complications and all that. So.
And the good thing is that we are going to talk about the diet, but after Diwali ke aaspaas,
One of our best dieticians, Dr. Tanveen, she's going to be taking this up.
Okay.
It's very interesting because you've got a lot of knowledge in this area, because we worked on this together for a long time. And she will give you guys a lot of idea on what exactly to eat and things. And maybe we can request Dr. Anjali to talk about the physical fitness part for insulin resistance. So actually, if you look at it, insulin resistance also is linked up with PCOS. The diet is the same, which Tamin will be addressing. And also sleep apnea. So if you have obstructive sleep apnea, you have PCOS, you're basically, the weight gain problem is because of insulin resistance in those areas. So, and the same diet you can use for diabetes as well. So I think in one shot you're going to have a total
treatment for everything.
Yeah, you're going to have an interesting next time.
So the most important thing, carbohydrates are not your friends. Just take care
of
your carbohydrates.
High glycemic index,
and if you've not been, you've made friends with the wrong thing, then work out and try and lose the, you know, the fat around the stomach.
Right.
And then you can actually lose weight more easily once you get rid of the
Since you mentioned about, we mentioned about glucose and things, another very interesting part is, and you said fatty liver. Fructose is called weapon of mass destruction.
Achha.
Fructose is worse than glucose, but that I think Praveen should.
Fructose, no,
fructose. So some fruits have very high levels, some less. So it's better to take those fruits with high fiber.
Okay, high fiber.
If you're asking between orange and Mosambi, I would choose Mosambi. Between tarbuza and tarbuza, I would take tarbuza because fiber is more. Glycemic index of fiber ka hai. That you will take the next time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Doctor.
Thank you.
I hope the session was useful for you.
Yeah, I hope so. I hope it is not too tough. Complicated. Because it is a very technical kind of discussion, that's why.
Yeah.
But anyway, I think we try to make it as simple as we could.
Yeah.